Hey, Michelle Glass here, and we are back looking at cranial bones. And our bone for today is the temporal bone. So you have, of course, a right temporal bone and a left temporal bone. Now, as we are looking at our bones of the skull, you want to make sure you are tracing out the bone using your suture line. So notice that our suture line includes this process here. We can see it going all the way around like this, and here as well. And then again, you can see that on both sides. We are looking here at the external view. You want to make sure that you're also looking at the internal view here. So right here is the temporal bone. So again, use your suture lines to trace that out for yourself. Here as well. Now, as we are looking at the temporal bone, we will see that there are two distinct parts or portions. You have a very flat part to the temporal bone. So this area here, you can see in the cut view how flat that bone is. That's called the squamous part or the squamous portion. So remember, we've seen the word squamous before with regards to flat. Okay, and again, you're seeing that on both the left and the right side. So make sure you're picking that out. Then we see sticking up into the internal cavity of the cranium, you have what's called the petrous part or petrous portion. So it looks a little bit kind of like a triangle sticking up into that area. The petrous part is the part that contains the middle and the inner ear. So as you get into the study of the middle and inner ear in your special senses chapter, you'll be studying that anatomy. There are these three tiny bones found in the petrous part of the middle ear, the malleus, incus, and stapes. So those are all going to be located there. The other way that I like to think about my temporal bone is that we have three holes and three processes. So we're going to start by looking at those three holes or three foramen. The first one for us to find is our external auditory canal, or you can call this the external acoustic meatus. So the terms auditory and acoustic are interchangeable, and canal and meatus are interchangeable, but typically you hear it either auditory canal together or acoustic meatus together. Now, this is, basically just the ear hole where sound waves are going into that middle ear. And so you can see that on both sides. When we are looking at the internal view, so you're looking at the backside of that petrous part. You will find here the internal auditory canal. Get it there. Having trouble? There we go. Internal auditory canal, or again, you can call it internal acoustic meatus. Okay? Notice that is right above the jugular foramen, which we named as part of the occipital bone. It's there on the border between the occipital and the temporal. So right there, internal auditory canal or internal acoustic meatus. I said there's three holes, right? So we need to do our last hole. We're going to find it right here. This is the foramen in between the mastoid process and the styloid process, and it's called the stylomastoid foramen. So we're looking here at the underneath side of the temporal bone. And we can find it here on that side. You look at it that way. See it? Okay. So we have three holes and we have three processes. So I've mentioned that this process here is part of the temporal bone. This process is called the zygomatic process. Zygomatic process. We have this large bump here. It's behind the external auditory canal. This is called the mastoid process, and you can feel that if you feel behind your ear. Mastoid process. Mastoid process. Processes are extensions of bone where a bone articulates to bone or where you have important muscle or ligament attachments. And then you have sticking here what's called the styloid process. It's named styloid as in like a stylus, so that'd be like a writing tool. So you can see that here. So remember, we had the stylomastoid foramen. So once you've identified your styloid process and your mastoid process, that's going to be a little bit easier for you to find the foramen, which is located right in between. The final structure to name on the temporal bone is the mandibular fossa. So fossa, remember, is a depression in bone. The mandibular fossa is going to be where the mandible, the lower jaw, articulates with the temporal bone. So that depression there is the mandibular fossa. Okay, so let's do a run through again. All right. So remember, you have a right and a left temporal bone. Remember, you're using your subject for your left and right. So because it's looking the same direction I am, then my model's right and my right are the same. I'm going to use my suture lines to trace out for myself exactly what is the temporal bone. Make sure you're able to see that equally well on both sides. And then go ahead and pop off the calvarium and take a look internally and make sure you're able to trace out your temporal bone there as well, on both sides. And that's hard to show. Okay. Then I like to pick out my flattened squamous part. You can see that here. And then my petrous part here. So that's that raised part of the temporal bone that contains the middle and inner ear structures. Okay, and then I go for my three holes and my three processes. So I'm going to start with my external auditory canal. I'm going to look next for my internal auditory canal and then my stylomastoid foramen. I'll do the same thing on this side. So external auditory canal, internal auditory canal, and stylomastoid foramen. And then do your three processes. So find your zygomatic process, find your mastoid process, and your styloid process. And make sure you can find that on both sides. Zygomatic process, mastoid process, and styloid process. And then don't forget your, let's see, that's a good view, your mandibular fossa, which is going to be where the mandible, lower jaw, is going to articulate in. There we go.